execute better in his sets. They're going to run a lot of plays for him, but sometimes he doesn't run the plays hard enough. Oklahoma did a nice job against him defensively, but they really need him to be their secondary scorer this afternoon.
Kansas versus West Virginia to get your college basketball Saturday started. Tharp attacks, but misses short, and a foul called already as Nadir Tharp passes.
Kansas foul called number 25.
And the foul's on Tarik Black is first. Now that Tarik Black is starting in place of the injured Joel Embiid, so Kansas needs Tarik Black to stay on the floor.
Bob Huggins in his typical self. There is no feeling sorry for Kansas without Joel Embiid. He said, you know, they've got a bunch of all-Americans to back him up, and Black was outstanding in his start the other night against Texas Tech.
Nathan Adrian trying to back in. 9 to shoot. First possession for West Virginia. Remy Debo is going to give it back to Juwan Staten. The junior from Dayton off the dribble, and there is the outstanding Juwan Staten getting to the rim.
Well, that's what he does, but you'll get there a lot easier without the big fella MB in the game or present on the bench.
First turnover for Kansas. Jayhawks get it right back.
MB doesn't block every shot, but he certainly protects the rim like no other, and Staten will certainly feels much more comfortable with this opportunity as they space the floor with his left hand. The game plan is to force him to his right, but I'm not sure you can take away either hand and feel very comfortable against Juwan Staten. He's that good.
Nathan Adrian gets the foul as Andrew Wiggins attacks. Wiggins will reset for Kansas onto Nadir Tharp, the junior from Worcester, Mass. Seldon. Wayne Seldon knocks down the three.
Seldon is a streak shooter, and if you give him any space, and on that possession, Adrian just gave him a little bit too much room on the perimeter.
So here's Juwan Staten, who leads West Virginia in just about everything, including assists, and give him another one. There's Aaron Harris.
Well, the big fella, the big Hugs on the sideline doesn't smile too much, but his inner self has a little small smile, knowing that's an important piece of today's offense.
Harry Ellis on the baseline.
West Virginia guards got to get a lot more support down low because Ellis is carving out space right at the rim, and they've got to protect that area, maybe send a trap down to the box.
Here's Harris off the screen. On to Adrian. Back-to-back threes for West Virginia. Nathan Adrian knocks it down.
This is a summer league game right now. Not much defense. Everybody feeling very comfortable on the offensive end.
Into Ellis again. Harry Ellis back-to-back buckets for Kansas.
Well, that's just way too easy. Remy Debo's got to do a much better job of defending before the catch and moving his feet. Ellis is just burying him at the rim.
West Virginia 3-for-3 shooting to start, including the back-to-back threes. Harris faces up. First miss, but there's an offensive rebound, and Williams is fouled. That's the second on Tarik Black. So just over 3 minutes in, Tarik Black has two for the Jayhawks. Well, the word on Joel Embiid, as Bill Self, is he definitely back for the Big 12 tournament? He said not definitely. Reevaluated tomorrow on Sunday. Joel Embiid did not make the trip from Lawrence, Kansas to Morgantown, West Virginia, nursing the sore back.
Well, as we all know, backs are very tricky, so you've got to be unbelievably cautious. And he played in a lot of pain in the second half of that Oklahoma State loss. And he was banged up and reportedly had trouble just walking out to the bus and getting on the plane. So this is a very smart move on their part. It's day-to-day, but I would expect him back at some point next weekend.
Important correction on that last foul. It was not given to Tarik Black. It was given to Perry Ellis. So Ellis has one. Black has one.
Ellis not only got the foul, he got a pasting on the sideline from Bill Self for not blocking out on the possession.
Meanwhile, for West Virginia, Terry Henderson is into the game. Number 15 for the Mountaineers. First action since February 15. He's been out with an illness that West Virginia has not disclosed. Wiggins down the baseline. There's Andrew Wiggins attacking.
Wiggins with his right hand, Carter, on the wing as he attacks the baseline. That help has to come much sooner and meet him outside the lane. He's not a good passer. He's going to score.
Aaron Harris on the wing. Takes it right at Wiggins. Missing around the 6'8 freshman, Andrew Wiggins. Seldon stepped on the baseline. Turnover, Kansas.
That's when Bill Self just shakes his head, because this team is so highly efficient, sometimes offensively and then sometimes they're not. But here you'll see Wiggins with his right hand. This is where he wants to go. He'll lean you one way and then the crossover, but the help comes way late. It meets him at the rim. It's got to meet him outside the lane. He's got a negative assist to turnover ratio. He's going to score.
Staden lost it out of bounds. It was touched by Nadir Tharp. So West Virginia hangs on.
But that's easier said than done. You meet him outside the lane, and he just rises up and shoots over you. He's so good. What you really have to do is make it tough for him on the catch. Make him catch it a little bit farther out beyond the three-point line where he's not as much of a threat. He's a streak shooter from the perimeter. Solid, but he's better going to the rim.
Devin Williams off the shot fake. Drives, and a foul called. It is on Tariq Black. That's his second. Andrew Wiggins, one of the finalists for the Wooden Award. But is he the Big 12 Player of the Year?
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by 5-Hour Energy. Focus is the feeling of clarity and alertness. It's the feeling you get from 5-Hour Energy.
Two of those 9 Kansas points from Andrew Wiggins, the freshman from Vaughan, Ontario. That's just north of Toronto. We know the scouts love him. We know the Jayhawk fans love him. But, Tim, is Andrew Wiggins the Big 12 Player of the Year?
I think he is. There's no question about it in my mind, having watched the league all year. Listen, when you have a league as great as the Big 12 is, with probably 7 teams on the NCAA, there's a lot of worthy players. But this guy has been rock solid, consistent all season long, become a better defender, and over the last 6 weeks, more aggressive to the rim, finishing better at the rim. Outstanding rebounder as well. He's a little lacking of his ball handling skills at time. He's a little loose with the basketball. He'll have some turnovers, as he did in the Oklahoma State game. But listen, he has been solid all year. Everything that's been put on his shoulders, and you add that into the mix, he's the Big 12 Player of the Year.
Now, you look at the freshman scoring, and actually when you do it by the numbers, McLemore, the all-time record, that was obviously set last year, breaking Danny Manning's incredible freshman season. Andrew Wiggins right now has 481 points. No, 483 now, 483. That is 13 points shy of what Danny Manning did in his freshman year.
Well, Melvin Edgem is clearly very worthy as well to be in the discussion along with his teammate DeAndre Kane at Iowa State, and this guy out on the floor right here that we see, number 3 in gold, has to be in the discussion. Juwan State plays 38 minutes a game, and everything is on his shoulders. And an outstanding guard for West Virginia.
If Edgem and Wiggins are both first team all Big 12, that'd mean 40% of the honors in the league go to Canadians. Kansas has made 4 straight field goals, but it's West Virginia with an 11-9 lead. Tariq Black is on the bench for Kansas. So an early appearance for Landon Lucas, the redshirt freshman from Portland, Oregon.
Bill Self already a little cranky here before even the 1 o'clock hour Eastern time with the officials. Not happy with that last call on Tariq Black, as West Virginia just kind of drove to the rim, and it looked like of a call that was made up.
Seldon was going out of bounds, tried to save it. Another Kansas turnover. West Virginia on the run with a 2-point lead. Staten nearly lost it. Adrian needs help. It's Harris, Wiggins guarding him. So Harris gives it up. Devin Williams. A 4-point lead early for West Virginia on 8th-ranked Kansas.
Nice. You can see their scheme. There's space in the court. Drive and kick.
Wiggins' second bucket.
Basketball, Wiggins.
Big trouble for West Virginia. They've got to do a better job of denying him the ball on the wing.
Williams power dribble, takes it right at Lucas and draws a foul on Lucas.
Well, we talked about Remy Debo playing defense before the catch on Perry Ellis, but on that possession, Landon Lucas just did not defend on the box. Devin Williams just powered and carved and lowered the shoulder and said, excuse me, freshman to freshman, I've got this spot.
Devin Williams has scored the last six for West Virginia. Seven in the game. Make it eight for the freshman from Cincinnati, who has double-doubles in each of his last two games, seven of them on the year, and a hot start for Devin Williams in West Virginia.
Now, Terry Henderson in the game. He hasn't practiced much. He's missed the last three games. He's lost about 18 pounds, gained six back. West Virginia's going to give him a go today.
Foul on the entry. That's called on Nathan Adrian.
Foul is called on West Virginia's Nathan Adrian.
So Henderson, the sophomore, who's averaging 12 points per game, but again, hasn't played since February 15th. He made the trip midweek, limited practice this week. So how big of an addition is Terry Henderson coming back to West Virginia?
He is huge because he is a lockdown, knockdown three-point shooter. Just put him on the floor with Harrison Staten. You've got three real capable scorers, but he has not practiced more than 30 minutes in the last week. He hasn't gone up and down the floor, but sometimes the adrenaline can give you an extra push.
Harris blocks by Wiggins. Williams falls off the block from Andrew Wiggins into the hands of Devin Williams. He has led the charge. West Virginia by seven. Timeout, Kansas.
Gate, you see West Virginia more aggressive, just looking to secure the rebound, and Kansas running out before they get possession, and Devin Williams throwing his body around on the box and at the rim.
That is 10 straight for Devin Williams, the freshman from Cincinnati. Spent his senior year at Montverde in Florida. He has been solid at the end of his freshman year. But a tremendous start. That's 10 points in the first 6 minutes against Kansas. Wiggins nearly walked. Gets it back to Frank Mason. Mason down the baseline. Finds Traylor, met at the rim by Debo. Jawan Staten on the run. Bumped! And Staten's headed to the free throw line.
Bob Huggins, his shoulder is going to pop out over on the bench because he wants to on that run to the rim by Staten. And this is where he is at his best. You give him a little space in the weak side. But first, West Virginia, great help side defense. They build the wall at the rim and then off to the races. The little shove and the block at the rim. No hoop, but Staten, what he does best, get to the free throw line.
So what is West Virginia doing so well to jump out to what is now a seven-point lead?
Well, right now, it's just playing with a little bit more energy on the defensive end. They knocked in a couple of shots, Carter. So now Kansas had to extend, which has opened up the middle of the floor. They've gone inside to Williams, and they've gained confidence with their defensive help. Weak side rotations have been quick and active.
Staten misses them both, so still a seven-point lead. Ellis nearly turns it over again. Turnovers on the road have been the problem for Kansas, especially in the losses at Florida and last weekend against Oklahoma State.
Don't discount the presence of a good player back in the lineup. Even if he doesn't give you a lot of quality, just his presence on the floor, Henderson, could mean something for West Virginia.
Ellis ends a 9-2 run. Mountaineers attack again. That is Henderson on the baseline. It's Wiggins on Henderson now. On to Remy Debo. Staten slips all the way to the rim. Jawan Staten.
West Virginia really spacing the floor. That possession, they had five players outside the three-point line.
Staten then called for a foul as Wiggins gets past it.
If you give Jawan Staten this much space, he is basically unguardable. And they space the floor. They've got five guys outside three-point line. A little dribble handoff. He changes direction, doesn't use the screen, and there's no help side because Kansas is just spaced too wide on the weak side.
Five fouls on Kansas, four on West Virginia. Trouble getting it inbounds. Mason just does get it into Selden. Trapped on the baseline. Traylor there to help him out. All the way out to Wiggins, who takes an inadvertent, apparently, elbow from Aaron Harris. After tight D off the baseline inbounds from West Virginia, that's the first on Harris.
Well, you never want to commit a foul at midcourt, but when Kansas is running their offense going south to north, that's a good sign for West Virginia. They're not attacking the rim. They're just trying to get the ball to someone in the same color jersey.
Ellis. Wiggins there for the board. How about a third chance? Tapped out. Ellis grabs it. Harry Ellis right back up with it. On the tip drill, Wiggins finally gets it to go. Andrew Wiggins on the offensive glass to cut it to five.
That's been an issue for West Virginia in conference. Minus three on the glass, and Kansas always strong. Plus nine on the season.
Staten long two. Juwan Staten. Did we say he was Mr. Do-Everything for West Virginia?
West Virginia's on about a 95-point pace right now. They've got some rhythm on offense.
Wiggins, that's going to be a held ball. Possession arrow will give it back to West Virginia.
Possession arrow to the Mountaineers.
Brendan Noreen for the tie-up.
Gary Brown and Devin Williams check in for the Mountaineers.
Well, this is just a mirror. Total opposite of the first matchup in Lawrence, where Kansas just pounded them in the paint, 48-18, and West Virginia is spacing the court, and they're going inside because they know the big fella is back home watching on television, and there is nobody at the rim to protect for Kansas.
Staten off the screen, misses at the rim. Brandon Green has the rebound. Into the corner for Green. Entry to Traylor. Jamari Traylor.
Basket by Traylor.
Kansas really never has gotten settled in their offense. They like to run the high-low stuff, but they seem sped up just because of West Virginia's energy and their toughness with their defense and their quick rotations and activity with their hands.
Harris. Fouled! Count the buckets, is Mark Whitehead. Aaron Harris and West Virginia have come to play against the Jayhawks. A 7-point lead in Morgantown. This is Bill Self and Bob Huggins in March 2014. In March 2000, back when the second round was really the second round, it was Bill Self in Tulsa against Bob Huggins in Cincinnati. That was the year that Kenyon Martin had the broken leg. Cincinnati got a 2 seed rather than a 1. Tulsa was a 7, and it was Bill Self's Tulsa Golden Hurricane upsetting the number 2 seed Cincinnati. Tulsa that year went to the Elite Eight, almost made it to the Final Four, lost in that regional final to Bill Guthridge's North Carolina Tar Heels.
Well, Bob Huggins, I'm sure, still wakes up in the middle of the night and says, how did we not get a number 1 seed from the committee who, just because they lost Kenyon Martin, dropped them to a 2, which Bill Self said was not correct. But he took the win and almost got to the Final Four. But those two guys, they look very similar. 14 years hasn't worn on them. You know why? A lot of wins, not many losses.
They look similar to themselves in 2000, right? They don't look alike, Bill Self.
No, right, exactly.
Huggins.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Aaron Harris.
Their winning percentages look alike, that's for sure.
Bob Huggins, 16th now on the all-time win list. The amazing stat for Bill Self. Kansas fans are familiar with it, but more conference titles than home losses in a decade plus with the Jayhawks. Truly stunning. That string of 10 straight Big 12 titles is now third all-time behind UCLA and Gonzaga as far as consecutive regular season conference titles. But Kansas trails West Virginia by 8 in the early going.
Kansas just can't seem to get into any offensive rhythm. They will push the ball, they'll run, they'll attack when they have it, and they'll shoot quick sometimes. But most of the time, they like to run their stuff, change sides of the floor, get into their high-low game, or run some pick-and-roll stuff on the perimeter. But right now, they're sped up, and they don't seem comfortable at all. See, West Virginia is pushing them to spots they don't want to be in offensively.
Nadir Tharp misses the 3, and a rebound for Williams and West Virginia. Quick outlet, Staten pushing. Juwan Staten draws another foul. That one's on Green.
Well, this is almost unfair. We could put a big fella trying to guard one of the elite guards in here. Brandon Green just saying, I'm trying to keep you, stay in front of you, but you change one way, go back the other, and it's almost like you're spinning and your head's atop. It's just spinning around because the change of direction in the body control for Staten is very unique in the fact that he gets to the free throw line, he has that mid-range game, but can't shoot three. He's not really a good three-point shooter, but if you lay off him, it just makes him better because it gives him more space to create angles.
And the Big Ten 6 Eastern, it's Michigan against Indiana. Then at 9, North Carolina versus Duke. That's Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV. A 10-point West Virginia lead on 8th-ranked Kansas. And foul trouble for the Jayhawks. West Virginia's already in the bonus. Black is sitting with 2. Landon Lucas has 2. So more pressure on the rest of the Jayhawks to step it up.
Well, it's not an equal opportunity situation here for Kansas, and that's Andrew Wiggins has to be more dominant right now. They need him to be more aggressive like he was on that last possession.
Answer, however, from Devin Williams. A red-hot Devin Williams, 12 points to go along with 4 rebounds in the first 10-plus.
Mark Bill is just letting him catch the ball wherever he wants to go, though, right around the rim.
Ellis, the answer inside for Kansas, and a foul on Remy Debo.
Well, the two guys that can do it are Wiggins and Ellis. And Ellis, some nights, will be aggressive like this. A lot of times he operates from the high post when Embiid is in the lineup. Today, he's trying to do his work around the basket. And he's got the experience and length and ability to score. And he's just keep working, and they need to keep looking for him on that spot.
Sophomore from Wichita now has 9, meaning 17 of Kansas' 22 have come from Andrew Wiggins and Perry Ellis. Staten on the wing. Noreen covered up, picks up his dribble. Williams, Staten, back cut, fouled at the rim. Jamari Traylor commits the foul as Staten cuts to the rim yet again.
Well, West Virginia runs a pattern motion, a lot of cuts to through the middle of the defense, basket cuts, and they wait for you to make a mistake, and their bigs can pass the ball in here. Just when you turn your head, Staten sees that opportunity at the rim. Nice delivery as well from the big fella Williams.
Staten, who spent his freshman year at Dayton playing for Brian Gregory, leads West Virginia, scoring, assists, field goal percentage, steals, and he is the only West Virginia starter who has not fouled out of a game this year.
And he plays 38 minutes a game.
Bob Cousy Award finalist. 1 of 2 here. Ellis at the top, guarded by Devin Williams. Ellis attacks again, draws 2 defenders, blocked inside by Noreen. Traylor tracks it down. Out to Wiggins. Andrew Wiggins down the lane, fouled, and takes a tough tumble into the first row of West Virginia fans.
West Virginia foul call number 34.
Gliding to the rim is what Andrew Wiggins does best. And here, with the right hand, coming to the middle of the lane, West Virginia has to step up way sooner, or else when he gets that little angle in the middle of the paint, he's pretty unstoppable.
So the projection for Kansas right now, they can get that number one seed, babe, be a number one in the East. Wichita State projected to be a number one in the Midwest, which means Andrew and older brother Nick would be together in St. Louis for the first weekend of the NCAA tournament, if those bracketology projections hold.
Good news for mom and dad. And Greg Marshall and Bill Self can get together and discuss maybe future scheduling. That's been an issue that they're talking about.
Yes, indeed. Devin Williams straight ahead.
They've got Devin Williams has been all over the court, mostly in the lane, but passing and also now the jumper.
Mason turns it over. Staden drops it off. How about the block at the rim from Wiggins? West Virginia hangs on. Staden crosses over on Green. Aaron Harris, a step on Wiggins, but he lost it last touch by Kansas, so the Mountaineers keep it.
Aaron Harris has to be careful. It's a crowded space out there in West Virginia for the most part. This afternoon has done a nice job of being patient and not forcing the opportunity until Kansas makes a mistake.
14 in the game for Williams. Make it 16. And another Kansas timeout. Devin Williams wide open on the baseline. West Virginia by 11 on Kansas.
The confidence is just growing from the young freshman from Cincinnati. And West Virginia has been an up and down team. They've showed parts of this middle of the conference where they could compete with everybody, especially that win against Iowa State, and get the great win against Oklahoma, Kansas State, Baylor, and got some work to do.
That's a resume on a team on the outside looking into the NCAA tournament, so it would take an awful lot for West Virginia, namely a win or two against Kansas if they meet in St. Louis in the Big 12 tournament. But Devin Williams has staked West Virginia to a double-digit lead. Solid start for the big man.
The thing is that he's done it from all spots on the floor. He's been very good defensively, but the cleanup man in the lane, he's got the ability to knock down that shot. You just saw him knock down the baseline shot, but also the point-blank delivery on the backdoor cut to Staten. Seven double-doubles. He's used his body well and playing with tremendous confidence against Kansas front line.
Double-doubles in the last two games for Williams. It's the most he's scored since non-conference against Purdue back in December. Zeldin follows the miss. Loose ball. Wiggins hangs on, but he touched the sideline. Devin Williams, the freshman from Cincinnati, leading an all-out assault on the Jayhawks.
Interesting to see, Carter, if Bob Huggins goes right at Tarik Black because he's back in the game with two fouls, and Devin Williams is clearly the man of the hour.
There's Brown. Williams calls for it right at Tarik Black. Williams gives it up. Staden with Wiggins on him. So Aaron Harris flips it out. Off the shot fake, Gary Brown, tough two. And a rebound for Ellis. So one touch on the possession for Williams, and that's it.
Really a better job of not letting him establish any position in the paint.
Seldon's second made three of the game for the freshman from Massachusetts.
Noreen got caught on Seldon, and he just flat-footed on the closeout.
Here's Williams, gives it up again. Staden off the screen. Wiggins recovers to get another blocked shot. And now Andrew Wiggins in transition, all the way to the rim. Andrew Wiggins. A blocked shot. He goes coast to coast and finishes it off with a dunk. But then on the other end, Andrew Wiggins reaches in for a foul.
But Jawan Staten got a little frustrated here and spends a little time turning to the official while Andrew Wiggins just runs by him. And he's got to run back on defense no matter what, if the call was good or bad. But Staten says, I'm coming right back at you and I'll get to the line.
So that's two for Staten.
I would have to say that doesn't happen very often. I have not seen every minute of every West Virginia game, but I think that Juwan Staten very rarely gets his shot blocked, so he was more stunned than anything. He said, that's got to be a foul. But very rarely, I'm sure, that he's guarded by a 6'8", long, fast, quick athlete like Andrew Wiggins.
to Black. Guarded by Williams. Tarik Black. Williams boards it. Staten pushing again.
West Virginia's defense has been outstanding. Just a pop in their step today.
Harris behind the screen. Aaron Harris knocks down the three.
Well, just a lot more energy from top to bottom for West Virginia, starting with Aaron Harris. He kind of played a sluggish game in Norman the other night. Couldn't get this look very easily. The timing was off coming off the screens. He wasn't cutting hard, but today he just needs a little bit of space and clearing and that rainbow jumper.
Off a season-low 5 points at Oklahoma on Wednesday. Harris already has 9 in this one. Offensive rebound, Seldon couldn't get it. And an over-the-back call. That foul is on Wiggins.
People smile when they get to play the Lakers now. Offensive numbers will be flying.
So maybe a chance for KD to bolster the MVP credentials against the Lakers.
First in wins when you have the ball against the Lakers. Russell Westbrook saying, you're 40.
Hayden gets them both. West Virginia by 12 on Kansas. Seldon, that's a tie-up. Possession arrow will keep it with Kansas.
Kansas is trying to get into their high-low game and attack from the wing and maybe get into the box, but they're running a lot of dribble handoffs on the perimeter, some exchanges, and West Virginia is switching everything. They've got the three guards in the lineup and doing a good job of staying in position and communicating and rotating quickly.
Wiggins and Williams draws a foul before the block. Watkins got a block, but fouls on the floor on Williams.
Andrew Wiggins, if Kansas is going to get back in this game, this is what he has to do. He has to be a little selfish now. He's got to attack when he can. He's got to move without the ball. They've got to look for him, and then when he gets it, West Virginia does not have an answer for him if they space the floor and he drives the lane or from the baseline.
Wiggins gets them both. So despite Andrew Wiggins' 13 points in the first, not even 15 minutes, Kansas down by 10. With Joel Embiid back in Lawrence. Terry Henderson. Good rebound from Traylor.
Bob Huggins feeling confident that Henderson can stay in the game. His position looks pretty solid.
Jamari Traylor finds Black, misses at the rim. Second chance, he misses the dunk. Tarik Black, 2 misses at the rim. Traylor hustles back to swat Juwan Staten on the alley-oop. I mean, off the backboard, Jamari Traylor swats it.
You better have had a big breakfast to play in this game today, because this is big boy basketball at the rim. You are going to get resisted, and there is flying bodies, arms, legs, and athletes to provide the defense.
Back-to-back misses at the rim by Tarik Black, including the dunk, and then a swat by Jamari Traylor to keep West Virginia from scoring in transition. Staten with 10 to shoot. Devin Williams in the corner. 5 to shoot. Staten on Wiggins. Staten crosses over. Floats it high off the glass. Around Wiggins with Traylor coming for another block. Juwan Staten somehow finishes. West Virginia by 12.
It looked like they had him corralled. It looked like they had him contested. It looked like they had him contained. But no, no thank you. He said, I'm too crafty. I'm too slippery. And I could some way, somehow, find a little crack in this defense. Okay, I'm going to back up, and here's the whole defense coming at me. I'll just get it up there on the rim and sneak it in. That's what scores do, Carter. Whew.
Staten gets a brief rest ahead of the under-4 timeout. Seldon, that's how you finish. After the missed dunk from Black the last time down, Wayne Seldon flexes the guns at the rim.
Kansas not wasting any time. I think this is what they have to do, space the floor and attack the rim, knowing West Virginia does not have a big-time shot blocker, especially with the three guards in the game.
Harris fouled on the floor.
A lot of activity, most of it at the rim, and this guy, the little guy, plays big on both nights, getting to the free throw line and finishing. And then the guard from Roxbury. This is what we do. We finish hard.
Is on the outside looking in. When we're done here, another big win of the Big 12 with Oklahoma State trying for its fifth straight win against Iowa State. First time they met, triple overtime. Then Missouri, Tennessee, both teams on the bubble. And then, of course, North Carolina, Duke, 9 o'clock Eastern time tonight on ESPN.
And who could forget the first Oklahoma State-Iowa State game, the triple overtime thriller? I don't think either team wants to do that heading into next week and in Kansas City. But Travis Ford's got his team playing well. Phil Forte and Marcus Smart were just outstanding in the second half in their win over Kansas State earlier this week.
Since that three-game suspension for Marcus Smart after the ugly incident in Lubbock, Oklahoma State has won all four games since Marcus Smart has come back. He's been on a tear.
Well, they beat these Kansas Jayhawks as well, where Kansas just got out of rhythm in the second half offensively. But tonight, this afternoon, it's been Kansas defense that has been lacking. West Virginia shooting over 60%.
Van Camp in the corner, misses the wide-open three, and somewhere in there, a foul spotted by Mark Whitehead.
Foul is called on West Virginia's number three, Juwan Staten.
It's on Juwan Staten. That's the second on Juwan Staten. We got a very brief rest during the under four timeout. So Wiggins back to the free throw line.
Well, Bill Self's been unhappy with the free throw differential at this point, 16-5. But Kansas needs to keep being aggressive. They got a couple calls in the last few possessions. And Traylor and Black are a low down low. They need to keep looking for them and let Wiggins attack. And we saw what happened when Seldon attacks the rim.
15 for Andrew Wiggins. Five of them from the free throw line. A single-digit lead, West Virginia on Kansas. 3:10 to go in the first half. Gary Brown off the handoff from Devin Williams. Staten again guarded by Wiggins. 10 to shoot. Staten gets two screens. Switch off, trailer on Staten, three to shoot. Staten turns it over late in the clock. Kansas on the run. Frank Camp finds a trailing Andrew White, who dribbled it off his foot for the sixth Kansas turnover of the first half.
Well, White turned it over, but Frank Camp should have never given him the ball there. There's nothing he could have done with that. Pull it out and get a good offensive possession. Go to your go-to guys, Andrew Wiggins. Don't go to White. There's no reason to give him the ball. He's just in the game to play some defense and give your perimeter guys a little bit of a breather.
Staten, entry pass into Brown on the block. Another block for Andrew Wiggins. That's three in the game for Wiggins.
Well, Kansas has done a better job defensively. Give Bill Self credit. He went back with Tarik Black with two fouls, and I agree with that move. You've got to trust your players to be able to play with two fouls in the first half, and he's done a real good job on Williams since he's come back in the game.
Shot clock winding down again. Nine to shoot. Staten, Ellis gets the switch out. It's Staten against Ellis. Into the paint, out of bounds again. There's just 2 seconds to shoot. Now a discussion as to who touched it last. It'll be Kansas basketball. So off West Virginia, Kansas ball, 2:10 to go in the half.
They closed the door on Staten pretty well, and that's the correct call. He lost the ball on his own.
Aaron Harris.
Mark Whitehead came in, had the better angle.
Frank Camp, the freshman from Wichita's North High School. Kansas weaves it around to Wiggins. Frank Camp off the shot fake. Elbow J. Over the back. Our journey.
It's the pass. When they tee it up tonight, it doesn't matter what they did in their last game. And maybe Carolina can get a two seed with a win, and maybe a lot if Syracuse doesn't get the job done at Florida State. So these teams are still working or positioning, but not positioning tonight. It's just enemy turf. Durham.
That 32-game home win streak by Duke, right now tied with Stephen F. Austin out of the Southland Conference for longest in the nation. The Lumberjacks and the Blue Devils. 0-for-2 at the free throw line. Watkins, there's a stoppage as there's a blood on Jawan State. So immediate stoppage at the 1:53 mark. So that means Staten is going to have to take an unwanted rest for West Virginia for the time being.
And the last possession, Bill Self was upset with Connor Frankham. And first Frankham with a poor decision in transition and a little weave there running out front. He just tried to take the ball off the bounce and take a jump shot. They need to work the ball inside, look for Ellis, and let Wiggins try to attack as well.
Wiggins turns it over. Aaron Harris behind the back. Henderson finishes. Welcome back, Terry Henderson.
He hasn't run up and down the floor hardly at all in the last 3 to 4 weeks, but that time he saw the rim and said, I know how to score.
Wiggins stripped again. Back-to-back turnovers by Andrew Wiggins. Harris pulls up. It is all West Virginia, a 14-point edge on the Jayhawks.
Well, the scouting report on Andrew Wiggins is when he attacks on the second dribble, try to close the door, force him to his left, he is not a good passer. Most of the time, he is going to look to score, and if you close the door before he gets into a shot motion, you can create some turnovers. And again, at the rim, West Virginia doing a good job of rotating and getting in front of him before he gets into his motion. West Virginia, their defense has just been outstanding. In the second half of the Oklahoma game, they had dead legs, and they weren't attacking Oklahoma today. They came out offensively with a lot of confidence, which gave them a little bit more of a pop in their step defensively, but they have a good game plan as well.
So if you're Kansas right now, down 14 on the road against West Virginia, how do you get it right?
They've got to slow down on offense. It seems like they're a little bit, they're sped up. You know, their defense has been better, like we said, in the last 7 or 8 minutes since Black came in the game and started guarding Williams. But right now, it's their offense that has been a problem. Quick shots, tight, not good spacing. Bill Self's had to use 3 timeouts in the first half. I would have to believe that hasn't happened all season long.
This is already the most points Kansas has given up in the first half this season. Ellis on the second attempt is fouled.
West Virginia foul was called at number 20, Brandon Watkins.
That's on Watkins.
First personal, 10, team foul.
Both teams are in the double bonus.
Terry Ellis with 2 shots.
The most allowed this season. The previous high was a 44 against Oklahoma.
Well, Bill Self clearly is upset with his point guard. He's got both Deer Tharp and Frank Mason sitting next to him. So he's just searching right now for any type of rhythm or chemistry on the offensive end of the floor. He's basically emptied the bench. He's gone right to the end of the bullpen looking for some answers out there against West Virginia.
Ellis gets them both. Mountaineers by 12. Staten around the screen, kicks it back out to Harris. Staten guarded by White. Drives, kicks, Devin Williams. Devin Williams has keyed the first half. Onslaught by West Virginia, 18 for Devin Williams. The most in a Big 12 game, and it all comes in the first half against the Jayhawks. Wiggins fouled. Bob Huggins irate. Wiggins fouled with 1.8 double bonus. He'll have 2 shots.
did a good job of coming up on Wiggins and forcing him to his left hand. He gets into the spin, and right now that is just a bailout. That is a flat walk, and I don't know where you get a foul from that.
And it's the second on Henderson.
Yeah, that's just an out-of-control player driving into the middle of the lane, and good defense and a bailout call.
Wiggins gets them both. He has 17, but Kansas only one field goal in the last 6 minutes. The Jayhawks give up 50 to West Virginia in the first half. Devin Williams, 18. Juwan Staden, 14. Aaron Harris, 13. It all spells trouble for Kansas and the chance at a one seed. Now we send you back to Kevin Connors for the Mazda Halftime Report.